So today we're going to talk about something new and different. MakerBase has been kind enough to send me a sample board of their MKS SGEN L version 2.0. Some of the unique things about this is it has an LPC 1769, which is a 32-bit processor, and it functions at 120 megahertz. It also has EEPROM that can hold up to 4 kilobytes of information so that you can store your configuration. Now I'm going to work my way around the board and tell you about the functionality. So to start with, we have the power supply, which is right here, and it connects with wiring down in here, and then you screw it down. And that can either do a 12 or 24 volt power supply. Over here, we have our heat bed connection. Then we have our first extruder, our second extruder. Then we have two fan ports. Now, the unique thing that they changed on this board was they added the ability to control two fans with signal pins versus the one on other boards. This is the port that you'll plug your extruder into. So this is your X stepper, your Y stepper, your Z stepper, E0 stepper, and E1 stepper. Now they've added a second connection for your Z stepper so that you can do two NEMA stepper motors. Now you can handle various types of boards for your steppers, such as the A4988, the DRV8825, the TMC2208, the TMC2209, which are both UART. And on the 2209, you can actually do overcurrent so that you don't need to use an end stop. So that would usually be for the X and the Y axis. The Z axis, you may use a different type of sensor. Over here, we actually have two ports for power. So they're either 12 or 24 volts based on the power that you're using for your power supply. And other types of steppers that I've actually left out, you may be able to use a TMC2130, and you may possibly be able to use the higher power steppers. I have to still investigate that. In addition to the actual stepper port, they actually give you breakout pins to add an auxiliary stepper port in addition to this. So if you want to use two steppers, you can actually connect a second one. I personally don't recommend that functionality, but you may feel that there's a need that you need to use it. But it involves tuning your steppers to a high degree. Over here, we actually have the pins that are used for sensorless homing. So you may have to jump these pins in order to use it. Then we have our end stops. We have our X minimum, our Y minimum, our Z minimum, our X maximum, our Y maximum, and our Z maximum. And the cool thing that they're starting to do is they're creating devices now that you can use these ports for something other than an end stop. One of the things that they've come up with is actually using a filament runout sensor that you can connect to these ports. Over here we have our servo ports. So you have two servos that you can use. And then we have our EXP 1 and 2 ports. These are actually used for an LCD. We also have a reset pin right here. And then we have our thermistor pins right here. This is used for telling temperature on your board. And it's usually integrated with either your heat bed or your two hot ends. Over here we have our auxiliary one port. And this can be used for various devices, but normally it's now used for a touchscreen display, otherwise known as a TFT display. Then they give you an additional set of pins down here that you can use for signal pins. And then they have pinouts here that you can connect a Wi-Fi module. Over here, we have our SD card, So I recommend that you use 128 megabit SD card, so some micro SD card. I need to use an adapter so I can actually connect it to my computer. So I'll leave links in the description for that, as well as affiliate links so that you can find this board online. Now, this is your serial USB connection right here that you'll actually use. But the very first time that you load this, you actually have to prepare with the micro SD card. So I'm going to pick this card up and show you how to insert it. So you're going to insert it like so. And then you're going to place this in your computer. Now you may hear a beep. Now one of the things I do have to tell you about this board is I believe they're still working on their manual. So there should eventually be a manual similar to the MKS SGEN L version 1.0. But they do have a wiki that I'll link to in the description. To start with, we have the SD drive in the computer. So we need to format it. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to go to format. And I'm going to format it as FAT32. So I'm going to click start. I'm going to say yes to actually formatting it. Now it's complete. So I'm going to close that out. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce you to the actual IDE for VScode. And the IDE is the Integrated Developer Environment. So the first thing that we need to do is actually load this on your computer. And inside my playlist, I'll have a link for this so that you can understand how to work with it. So you'll figure out how to install from that. But it has PlatformIO already on it. So I'm going to go over to the Explorer. Then I'm going to click Open. And I have an unzipped version of Marlin bug fix. And the reason that is because Marlin has not released this yet as a build. I'll put a link to both the firmware download over here for Marlin firmware. This is for 32-bit boards, so you got to use the 2 version, meaning 2.0.6, or the bug fix version. But because I know that it's going to be released soon, I actually pulled it from here. So let's go back over to VS Code. And since it's unzipped, I have to go one level deeper. Then I can say select folder and it'll pull all of those elements in. So the next thing that we normally want to do is go over to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder. Inside here we have boards.h. So I'm going to click on that and I'm going to do a search on MKS underscore SGEN L. And there are several versions of this. The one that we're working with is the LPC 1769. That's 120 megahertz processor. So I'm going to actually highlight this board right here. This is ours. And I'm going to copy that. And the board is called board underscore MKS underscore SGEN underscore L underscore V2. So I'm going to close out of that. And I'm going to go over to, I'm going to minimize the source folder. Then the core folder, and I'm going to do a search on motherboard. And this will bring us to what our default motherboard should be. Now, because Marlin was developed with the RAMPS board, that's not what we're using. So we have to highlight that and paste over it what we just copied. So the next thing that you need to do here is actually change your serial port from 0 -1, and then we're all set with a basic configuration to actually build, except we have to change our platform io.ini. This is our environment, So our default environment right now is set to the RAMPS board, which uses a Mega 2560 chipset. But the chipset that we use is the LPC 1769. So once that is set, you can actually click on this button here called Build. It's also known as Compile. And then once we have loaded at least one build on the actual device with the actual SD card, we can actually use the upload button with the USB cable. So I'm going to actually click on the build for now, and it's going to download the current framework that we're using. As you can see down here, it's actually pulling in files that we may need to compile, and it's starting to compile them as we speak. So this is actually the build portion that's occurring. So this is going to take a few moments. So I'm going to pause the video and I'll come back and explain the other steps. Now that the build or compile has completed, we can check to see if it succeeded, which it says it has. And we can also verify up here that it was successful. So what we need to do, just in this case for the initial load, is we need to click on .pio, open that folder, then the build folder, then the LPC 1769, and then right click and go to Reveal in Explorer. Then you're going to click on the folder, and inside the folder you're going to find a firmware.bin. You're going to right click on that and you're going to say send to, and you're going to send it to your SD card. So we can verify now that it's there by clicking on our SD card. And as you can see, it says firmware.bin. So we're going to remove that and we're going to place it in the MKS SGEN L version 2.0. Okay, so we have the SD card here. So we're going to remove the micro SD card from here and we're going to place it right inside here. The next step is to connect the USB cable, and you should see a flashing light when the firmware is installing off the SD drive. So here we go. So as you can see, we got some flashing lights over here. It looks like it loaded. And so what we're going to do next is we're going to verify that it's actually working. Okay, now that we actually have the USB drive connected because we have firmware loaded, we can see that it says firmware.cur in all capital letters. That means that it's been converted into the current firmware, thus cur in this case. So to test that it actually works, we're going to go to our desktop. And we're going to go to our print run directory, then pronterface. Inside the pronterface folder, we're going to click on the connect button. And as you can see, it says printer is now online. That means that it's actually working. So I'm going to test the end stops. Now there's no end stops connected, so this will show what their current state is in. So I'm going to test it with the G code of M119. And press enter. And as you can see, they all say triggered because there's no connection. Keep them separate. So if you like my tutorial, please like and subscribe. And for all the people that have been tipping me, thank you very much. The list is getting kind of long for me to recite. And have a nice day.